Hey folks, Dmytro from Automfart Studio here, and today we're going to be talking about heuristic evaluation. What it is, how you do it, and how it can help you solve 90% of your usability problems. Without further ado, let's get started. So, heuristic evaluation. Let's unpack the meaning of each word. In a nutshell, a heuristic is a fancy word for a rule of thumb, and heuristics help us create mental shortcuts that help us solve problems quickly and efficiently. An example of a heuristic would be assuming that it's going to rain soon when you see dark clouds approaching. Not many of us are meteorologists or have a sound understanding of how weather works, but we don't have to. It is still a fairly reasonable assumption to make. From an evolutionary standpoint, these shortcuts help us navigate the world with less friction, which increases our chances of survival as a species. Now, what does this have to do with user experience design, you may ask? Well, the same principles apply to designing digital products. Let me explain. UX is a discipline that hasn't been around for very long, since its subject matter, which is human-machine interaction, is fairly recent. The term UX itself was only coined in 1993 by Don Norman. And although UX is a relatively young field of study, researchers have already developed a series of heuristics, rules of thumb if you will, that help you determine whether your design is good. Even without conducting thorough user research, you can reasonably assume that your design is faulty if it breaks some of these principles. And checking your design against these heuristics is what we call heuristic evaluation. And what exactly are these heuristics? I'm glad you asked. There are a few sets of UI/UX design heuristics out there, just to name a few. So there's Ben Schneiderman's 8 Golden Rules of UI Design. There's Jill Gardhardt-Powles' 10 Cognitive Engineering Principles. There's Alan Cooper's About Face 2.0, The Essentials of Interaction Design. However, the set of heuristics that is the most common is Jacob Nielsen's 10 Design Heuristics. Let's go through all of these. So the first heuristic is visibility of system status, which means that users should know the system status at all times and get feedback on interactions with it. An example of that would be writing an email, hitting send, and then nothing happens. The email was actually sent, but the system didn't communicate that to you. Now, how should you know if everything went well if there's no feedback? Such an email client would suck. The second heuristic is the match between system and the real world. It means that the system should resemble the experiences that users already had. An example is, do you ever notice how things like icons or button shapes are based on their real-world counterparts? That's because systems should be built on top of what users already know, rather than start from a blank page. The cart icon looks like a cart, the search icon looks like a magnifying glass, the download button looks like a floppy disk, etc. The third heuristic is user control and freedom. It means that users should be able to reverse their action if they make a mistake. And do you know how sometimes we accidentally delete the document we've been working on for days? Because I certainly do. Well, usually control Z or going back to the bin always comes to the rescue, but we can only imagine the horrors of a world without the undo button. The fourth heuristic is consistency and standard, which means that similar system elements should look similarly. Now imagine if an app with 4 instances of search had different icons for it. That's no fun for all the parties involved. The heuristic number 5 is error prevention. Mistakes are inevitable, but it's the job of a designer to minimize the number of them. Heuristic number 6 is recognition rather than recall, which means that users should be able to interact with the system without prior information or context. Do you remember what you had for breakfast yesterday? Well, neither do I. For the very same reason, we can't be bothered to memorize every single button or action. Users have to be able to recognize patterns with little to no prior preparation. The heuristic number 7 is flexibility and efficiency of use. Both new and experienced users should be able to efficiently use the system. And you've likely walked or driven from home to work thousands of times. You can do it even with your eyes closed and take the shortest route in the meantime. That doesn't mean, however, that there's no need for direction signs for those who are new to the neighborhood. A good interface should appeal to both of these user types. Heuristic number 8 is static and minimalistic design. It means that you should declutter as much as possible, because less is more. Heuristic number 9 is helping users to recognize, diagnose, and recover from mistakes. Pretty much means that you should make error messages understandable and suggest ways to fix an error. So imagine your English teacher, instead of underlining and correcting mistakes in your essay, writing something like error 325, pronoun misuse under it. That wouldn't be very useful. It's a fictional situation, of course, but that's what a lot of products do. they display highly technical error codes instead of just telling you plainly what's wrong and how to fix it. And finally, the 10th heuristic is help and documentation. So if a user has a hard time interacting with your app, make sure there's help that's easily accessible. No matter how great your UX is, some people will still be confused. And that's not because the UX is bad or the person is stupid, but because people are people and they get confused and make mistakes. What you should do is offer help when necessary through either a guide, manual, live customer support, etc. Now that we have an idea of what Nielsen's heuristics are, let's go over why you should care in the first place. So take a look at the graph on your right. So according to the Nielsen-Norman group, the world's leading UX research authority, appointing 5 to 8 heuristic evaluators should identify over 80% of usability problems, which gets you in the sweet spot of identifying the most issues with the least effort. So right at about 11 experts, the identified problems start to plateau, so there's no reason to hire more people. And yes, you do need multiple design experts. More on that later. And hopefully, I don't need to tell you that poor usability is synonymous with poor conversion, retention, adoption, and ultimately revenue. I hope I've managed to convince you that heuristic evaluation is pretty valuable, or at least gave you some food for thought. And now, let's go through the 7 steps you should complete. Step number 1 is to outline the scope of your evaluation. For example, that could be either mobile version, the new invoice creation flow, the legacy onboarding design, whatever. Step number 2 is to start looking for experts. Again, you need 5 to 8 experts, so if you don't have them in-house, consider looking for them on platforms like Upwork or Toptal if you're looking for a freelancer, or go to Clutch or Good Forms if you're in search for an agency. Step number 3 is to aggregate everything you know about your users to get the evaluators up to speed with your user intelligence. Make sure you document all you know about your users, how and why they use your product, etc. Step number 4 is to set up an evaluation system. For example, you can categorize the issues as critical, severe, minor. You can also assign things like ease of fixing or impact, etc. Whatever category suits your needs will work. Step number 5 is to analyze and summarize the findings in a document, while step number 6 is to prioritize the issues that are most severe and easiest to fix first. And then you just fix them. And by the way, don't worry about memorizing all of this. We have a template for heuristic evaluation, and you can access it with the link in the YouTube video description. Now that we went through the heuristics and evaluation process, let's take a quick look at the heuristic evaluation report example. Note that it's not a universal report template. We use this particular format because we found it the most informative and efficient. So with that disclaimer out of the way, let's take a look at my screen. Here you can see a snippet of a heuristic evaluation we've done for one of our clients. As you can see, this review is structured based on heuristics. And right here, you can see a checklist we've prepared for ourselves to help make our reviews more consistent. This larger part right here is our working area. We use it for our own convenience and generally do not present it to the customer. In this working area, based on these criteria and heuristics, we would go through the whole app or just a certain module and look for any usability issues. We then document these issues here. As I mentioned before, we'd have at least 5 of our designers take a look at the product to make sure we spot at least 80% to 90% of the usability issues. Once we're done with documenting and prioritizing the issues, we then move on to presenting them. Here you can see a bit of the intro screen. It helps give our clients context, explain the methodology and the value of the document. And there, we would outline these issues and their severity in a way that's understandable and easy to read. That way you can focus on fixing the most pressing usability problems first, to see the impact on your metrics as soon as possible. And finally, we would have a summary table with the number of the issues, their severity, and the module we found them in. This helps quickly gauge which parts of the product need the most improvement and which heuristic requires the most work. And that's it. This is the bulk of what you would see in a heuristic evaluation report. The next step from here is planning the design improvements based on usability and business priorities, implementation capacity, etc. So we've talked a lot about heuristic evaluation, but I thought it would make sense for us to go through pros and cons as well. So the first pro is that heuristic evaluation is quick and cost-effective. You can use the internal resources you already have in place to administer an evaluation. The pro number 2 is that it's also flexible. You can conduct a testing session at any stage of the design process. You can evaluate wireframes, prototypes, live products, or all of the above. The pro number 3 is that heuristic evaluation is exhaustive. It enables you to comprehensively scan your product's current UX design. pro number four is being able to rank the severity of the issues. You can organize usability issues into categories and solve them in accordance with their severity. Finally, there's also compatibility. You can combine multiple usability testing methods at the same time. Pretty neat, right? Now that we went through the pros, let's discuss the cons as well. The first con that you might come across is a shortage of usability experts. Finding an experienced usability evaluator can sometimes be a challenge depending on the niche of the product being tested. To make matters worse, you need to find 5 to 8 experts. What you might also struggle with is the lack of experience among the evaluators. Onboarding newbie evaluators may influence the value of the usability issues identified. This means that you need to invest time to quickly get the evaluators up to speed. The third con is something referred to as false positives. Issues that are flagged based on heuristics may not necessarily cause a negative user experience in practice. Heuristics work most of the time, but not all the time. Remember the example I had with the dark clouds that indicate rain? Well, dark clouds may disperse or get pushed elsewhere by the wind. Just like the clouds, the problems identified by heuristic evaluation may turn out not to be problems after all in the eyes of your users. Now that we went through all of the major aspects of heuristic evaluation, let's go through everything again to consolidate the information we've just learned. A heuristic is an educated guess, a shortcut an experienced professional can take to accurately predict certain outcomes. Professionals in UX are able to evaluate a product based on these shortcuts. This process is commonly referred to as heuristic evaluation. A set of 10 heuristics that are used most commonly is known as Nielsen's 10 usability heuristics. These 10 heuristics are usually what UX professionals compare the products against to conduct an evaluation. To make the most out of the experts' opinions, you need at least 5 professionals. You can either talk to your in-house design team or hire external help. Having 5 to 8 evaluators will help you spot at least 80% of the usability issues. The heuristic evaluation session usually entails outlining the scope of the evaluation, looking for experts, transferring the knowledge you already have to the professionals, then setting up an evaluation system, the evaluation itself, and then summarizing and analyzing the findings. Then you prioritize them and finally fix these issues. That brings us to the end of this video, so thank you a ton for sticking till the very end. You can find this information in written form on our blog by following the link in the description. Also, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe. There are more videos to come.